What's good? Welcome back to a new reaction. This time to Spider PS4 Trailblazers at D23. Right, so I'm gonna react to it now. And also, guys, I don't know if you're here, but my mom's watching Alien 3 right now. She's watching the whole series. So if you hear like anything that isn't a game player, my boy, that's mom watching Alien 3. She's blaring. I can hear it right now. Oh yeah, one thing I got to mention, guys, we have reached 41 subscribers. Yay! Yeah, guys, I mean, like, thank you guys for getting me to 40, liking my videos, subscribing, commenting, sharing you guys my show, and you guys support, all that jazz that every other YouTuber tells you whenever they hit a subscribe button. So yeah, let's react. In 3, 2, 1. Alright, let's see what you got for me now, Insomnia.
The greatest thing about working on a Spider-Man game is that you're working on a Spider-Man game.
Very true. Very true. Yo!
The hardest thing is that it's a Spider-Man game.
They copied that from Amazing Spider-Man 2.
And I think that's how we go into every game and come here. There's this push to really get it right.
One of the most compelling things about Spider-Man is just when Peter Parker and Spider-Man the worlds collide. And we've tried really hard to piece the stories together to create a story that is not necessarily just a superhero story.
Human
story as well. Oh my god. Spider-Man is a little different. He's older. He's 23, so he's been Spider-Man for 8 years. And kind of like an athlete in the prime of his career, he's starting to get good at the Spider-Man thing.
The nice thing about playing an experienced Spider-Man is that he's already familiar with his powers, right? He's not just discovering them.
We always think of Spider-Man as we call him the acrobatic improviser.
Yeah, right, the swing's a lot faster now.
Not only how he can take advantage of when the enemies are positioned, but what around him. Could he use this object to grab with his webs and throw it at an enemy? We want people to not only see the enemies in front of them, but the environment around to take advantage of both of them.
He also knows that the criminals out in the city know how he works as well, so he's got to mix it up.
So even though he is more experienced, the challenges are going to be bigger than they ever faced before.
Spider-Man has a rich history of having great stories.
Yo!
Part of our story is the duality between Peter Parker and being Spider-Man. What's cool about Mr. Negative is that he also has a duality. He's got his positive side as Martin Lee, who runs the homeless shelters in the city, but he also has his negative side.
When Peter makes the connection that the leader of the Inner Demons is the guy who my aunt works for, we got the perfect collision of those two worlds.
Right.
So many people have their own vision of what Spider-Man should look like, what he should sound like, and in the end, we just have to put a new and fresh twist on who he is.
And for us, it's really, really important to deliver those big spectacle moments, those near impossible scenarios that only someone in Spider-Man can survive, and put you in that action. There's out there for
you. Insomnia.
What this character means to people looking here. We're making this game with a lot of heart. Whatever it takes to give people the ultimate Spider-Man experience, the game that they've been waiting for.
That's called Ultimate Spider-Man! That's the Ultimate Spider-Man. Oh, yeah, let's get to the top of that first one. Arriving 2018. Oh my god. Oh, man. I already know this game's gonna be my game of the year of 2018. I can already tell. Oh my god, guys. You can tell the passion, Insomnia, and the love they have for Spider-Man, which I am in because I fucking love Spider-Man. Wearing this, the Spider-Man t-shirt right now. I mean, he's my favorite superhero of all time. And I have so much memories with him. In fact, Spider-Man 3 right here. In fact, actually, Spider-Man 3 right here, my original DVD copy of it. This was my most anticipated movie of all time back when I was like 7 years old. And when I first saw the teaser trailer for it, while I was scouring the internet, I was so hyped for this movie just because of the black suit Venom, because that's my favorite version of Spidey. And Venom's my favorite Spider-Man villain. And when I saw it as a kid, I fucking loved it. It was like my favorite of the Sam Raimi trilogy. But as I've grown older, of course, I know that Spider-Man 2 is a far superior movie to this, but I still fucking love this movie, and Amazing Spider-Man 2 is my favorite Spider-Man movie because how Andrew Garfield nailed Spider-Man. Yes, the movie has its flaws, and sure, maybe the Sam Raimi did a lot of things better than that, but still, you can tell Andrew Garfield loves Spider-Man. I mean, look when he was announced Spider-Man at Comic-Con, you can tell that he absolutely fucking loves his character. I love Tom Holland and Homecoming, but Andrew Garfield, though. Yeah. And you can tell it's the age DVD has had in like the 10 years I've had it. But yeah, guys. Oh, man. I cannot wait for this game. I'm so hyped for it. I'm so hyped for this game. I cannot wait to see it in 2018. Day one pre-order. I know I'm going to get like the limited edition console for, there's like a limited edition PS4 Pro that's going to announce that's going to come with this game. I'm going to buy that. If there's a collector's edition, I'm going to buy that too because I fucking love Spider-Man. So yeah, guys. Amazing trailer. Can't wait. Yeah, guys. Leave a like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're new. And as always, come back for more. See you guys then as well. Also, follow me on Instagram and Twitter if you feel like it. See you guys next time.